The last and final class of system is stable and unstable systems. What are stable and unstable systems? For any system, if you give a bounded input, that means a finite input, if the system also produces a finite output or bounded output, then such systems are known as stable systems. Any system which produces an unbounded or diverging output for a bounded input, then such systems are known as unstable systems. Now let us go into the video and analyze some examples for stable systems and unstable systems.
Stable and unstable systems. Consider an example of a pendulum. Here we are applying a force at the knob of this pendulum, and let us call that as the input signal x of t. And based on the applied force, you can see that there is an angular deviation from the vertical position. Okay, and that angular deviation is the output signal. So I am giving an input signal, I am pulling it. Okay, for that pull, what is the angular deviation? That is my output signal. Here in this case, we know that even if we apply force and leave it, the gravity will try to pull it back to the original vertical position, and also it will experience air drag, or you can say friction, okay, air friction, when we move it to the right side or when it is coming back to the left side. So for this bounded input, so you are giving some bounded input, that is some finite input, you are only giving a minimum force. For that, it will produce an angular deviation of minimum angular deviation, maybe this much angular deviation. After that, it will come to the equilibrium position and it will remain in this position, right? And you can say that for this bounded input, it produced a bounded output. So this system is a stable system because for the bounded input, it produced a bounded output. Now coming to this pendulum, this is the vertical pendulum. So in the case of a vertical pendulum, actually it is fixed at the bottom, okay, and this is the vertical position, right? If you pull it from this location, you know that even though there is an air drag, here gravity is acting in the opposite direction, and finally this pendulum will topple down and it will become unstable, right? It will become unstable. It will not go back to the original position. It will topple down. This is an example of an unstable system. Why? Because I have applied only a very small finite input. Okay. For the small input itself, it created a very large movement of angular deviation, and now it is not able to go back to the original position. So for a very small input, it produced an unbounded output. Okay. So because of that reason, this is an unstable system, right? So this kind of stability is known as BIBO or BIBO stability. So what is my BIBO stability? That means for a bounded input, if the system produces a bounded output, then such systems are known as BIBO stable. Let us take another example of an unstable system. Here we have considered depositing some amount in the bank, okay, x of n at the beginning, and let us take y of n. So the y of n is calculated as 1.01 into y of n minus 1 plus x of n, right? And we have invested some 1,000 rupees in the beginning, and we are not withdrawing any money from this account, and there is no bank charges. Assume that ideal bank and there is no bank charges. In that case, because of this equation, after some time, maybe let us take 50 years, after 50 years, you can see that this amount will blow up, okay, because of the compound interesting, and it will become unstable. So this is an example of an unstable system. because there is no withdrawal and there is no bank charges. Because of that reason, if it follows this equation, actually here this is the previous year sum into 1.01. Even though the increment is very small, it will result in a huge amount of value after some time, right? So this is an example of an unstable system. So formally we can define it like this. If every bounded input, okay, this is very important, okay, you should not give unbounded input and then don't complain that it is an unbounded output. So if you are giving a bounded input, then at the input terminal result in a bounded output. If you are giving a bounded input and you are getting a bounded output, then the system is Bibo stable. Otherwise, the system is not Bibo stable. We can call it as an unstable system. I hope that is clear.
I hope now you understand the concept of stable and unstable systems. Stability of a system physically means that there is some mechanism inside the system which dissipates energy so that we will get a bounded output. After some time, the output will die out. For example, in the case of an RC circuit, if you give a bounded voltage, the resistor and capacitor in the RC circuit will dissipate the energy in the form of heat so that we will get a bounded output. In the case of a moving automobile, if we apply some constant force, it will create a velocity for the car, and when the velocity increases, the friction also increases so that the output will not go beyond a limit or the output will not become unbounded. So we get a bounded in output for the bounded input. So such systems are known as stable systems. In an engineering perspective, we need to design stable systems for our applications. I hope that is clear. So with that, we come to the end of the lesson. So in this lesson, we have tried to classify different systems based on their properties. Each and every classification is important. We will analyze about them in the upcoming lessons. Thank you very much for your patient listening.